Okay, here's a new format for you. We're testing out a new format, kids. What format is that? That's the format of me driving and speaking into my phone headset, then later coming back home and putting video game footage to that audio. I don't know if this is going to work. I don't know if it's not going to work. I'm kind of inspired by Shane Armand Rose Passenger Seat Radio. Hell, you're in the car anyway. It seems to be the only time I have to do anything like this. So let's just see what happens, shall we? Man, you know what I want is a cup of coffee. Not just a cup of coffee, but a cup of decaf coffee because it's late in the evening. Maybe I'll just go to the Waffle House and get me one decaf cup of coffee, and you'll come with me. You'll come with me to the House of Waffles to procure this decaffeinated beverage of life. I don't know why I'm doing it. Hell, I'm just doing it. Just doing it! I had a cup of coffee earlier at the Starbucks, and it was lovely. Yes, it was lovely. Maybe I'll get a side order or something, you know? A side order of something. Please, something. Give me a side order of something here. For crying out loud, I need an order of something. This side order of... So, what's been going on with me? Well, I went back up to the snowy tundra of... Actually, there was still snow on the ground. There's still snow on the ground in Alaska, I'm happy to report. I stepped on some of it. It was lovely. It's kind of compacted, you know. It's been in that melty phase, but what used to be a giant pile of snow is now just a little mound that you can stand on and be proud of yourself and throw a baseball at somebody. And, yeah, it's good. I had a good time there. I was there for 2 weeks. I was initially set to be there for a week, and I was there an extra week. She offered to extend it 2 weeks, and I should have taken it. I would have been coming back today if I had taken her up on that. But I may be moving back up there. We'll see. We'll see how these things pan out. You never know how these things pan out. But in the meantime, what else have I been doing? I ain't been doing nothing. A lot of despairing, you know? A lot of despairing. After elbow bust, not even a full week before I was supposed to leave, I had a knee bust, laid up the first day. Something just goes out down there. I don't know what it is. Sometimes I'll wake up and I know by the way that the angle of my sleeping on my side that, oh, the knee's out again. And there were a couple of times in Alaska where I thought, oh, this doesn't feel right. I think it's going out again. And then I stepped down on it kind of hard, and whatever it was that was out of place was back. It felt fine. Like, oh, it's starting to hurt. I step off a curb, boom. Now I'm back in business. Everything feels normal. I don't know what the hell that is. I don't know what's going on down there. But I will say this. You know, my knees, my whole life, my knees haven't been right. I've got that Osgood Schlatter, whatever. And they never grew out of it. They never came together right. I showed it to a doctor, and he was just like, man, that's the damnedest thing I've ever seen. Hey, it's me, your doctor. That's the damnedest thing I've ever seen. Well, doc, it ain't fun. Something's wrong with them. They just don't work like knees need to work. And when they don't, boy, it messes up all the other stuff that's connected to them, which is everything. Indirectly or directly. Oh, this dipshit. There's some dipshit behind me with his brights on. Right in my face. These stupid Ford F-150s. Oh, that's a sheriff. That dipshit is a sheriff. Ho-ho! Well, sheriff dipshit, you need to tone down your lights, my friend, because they are in my face. My face, Sheriff Dipshit. Anyway, these Ford F-150s, It's like they're huge, these cars. Trucks have gotten so big here that it's just a waste. Like, you should be totally ashamed to be driving these things. It's like an overcompensation for a mediocre manhood or something. They've gotten ridiculously big. And for no reason other than they're trying to skirt EPA regulations. That's why they're big. And then they propagandize everybody to think they need an SUV to be safe because they just made these all these cars that they're afraid are going to mow them down. I hate it. I hate what, like, this country has just become. I'll tell you what it's become, Chester. It's become one big stupid road with cars that are designed to not be able to see children at play when they pull out in a quiet neighborhood and just mow over as many human beings and their pets as they possibly can. That's what this country is. It's just Ford F-150s and Chevy Silverados mowing over children, little people, and pets. You've got to wear stilts just to not be killed in this country. Hi, this message was brought to you by the Firemen's Association of America. Not the Firemen's Association of America, no. We could only get one fireman to join, and he is dead. He caught fire by associating himself too hard. And now, look at him. Look at him, he's on stilts! Okay, I'm on my way to the Waffle House. We'll get a cup of coffee. And you know what? You might just be able to join me for this cup of coffee. I might just be let you join me for this cup of coffee. Just a decaf cup of coffee. That's my big plans for the evening. He's going to get this Waffle House cup of coffee. I wonder if anybody's going to be here tonight. It's 10:11 on a Saturday night, the first day of the month. I got to pay my health insurance, my hundreds of dollars in health insurance, so that I can have the privilege of turning around and paying thousands of dollars if, God forbid, anything happens. What is this country coming to? Mow me over! I'm wearing stilts over here. Mow me over with your health insurance, Chevy Silverado. I almost missed the turn for the Waffle House, and my seltzer just went in the floor. Oh. Dear seltzer, what game should I play to accompany this trip to the Waffle House? Maybe the new Burger Time. Maybe I'll get a burger. Maybe with no bun, of course, with no bun. There don't seem to be lots of folks here right now, so got the place to myself. Gonna come in, get a decaf cup of coffee, and then the world is my oyster.
Hey, just for here, y'all have decaf heated up, right?
Thank you.
Can I just get a small bowl of chili with cheese? Can I get shredded cheddar? What? Oh, you just have the regular. Well, that'll work. I mean, if it melts in there, it'll be good. I think so, yeah. Is there a truck backing up in here? What's that noise? For this shift, what's usually your big rush time?
Anywhere between 9 and midnight.
Okay. So it's not like after the bars get out?
We don't have any bars in here.
Well, that was a fun time. That waitress was a low talker and very crabby. I can't say as I blame her for being crabby. She was an older lady working the night shift at Waffle House. I'm sure that's not what she set out to do at the beginning of her life. Now I'm heading back to the place where I belong. Let's put on our seatbelts, shall we? So we don't die. Putting on our seatbelts so we don't die. That wasn't bad. That little piece of chili and that other thing, that wasn't bad, you know. The cup of coffee, I had 3 cups of decaf. And I don't mind telling you that I'm starting to feel a little tired. a little tirade. What am I supposed to play when I get back? What I really like to do is just work a spreadsheet. Just put numbers in a spreadsheet. That's the game I really want to play. VisiCalc. I want to play VisiCalc. Will you be still watching if I'm playing VisiCalc instead of pretending to be a special little businessman? Going, I'm a special little businessman. You know, let me tell you, let me send you over to a good, fun channel. It's this Big and Funky Productions. Have you heard of this guy, this Big and Funky Productions? He does a lot of Atari 7800 content, but he's also a professional wrestler, and he makes horror movies, comedy horror movies on the side. And he's a professional wrestler, and I think he's a bass player in a funk band. Big and Funky Productions, Funk Master V, or Vinny, as he goes by, Vinny Vineyard. And it's such a great marriage of disparate elements. Wrestling, as they say, the Atari 7800, and these comedy, low-budget, micro-budget, if you will, comedy horror movies. He's real clever. He's a lot cleverer than I am. And we both have similar backgrounds in that we've worked in broadcast media. Go check him out. Big and Funky Productions. Search on the Atari 7800 Forever website. Like that, he runs that too. You might find it there. Anyway, it's a good time. Vinny Vineyard. I'm probably going to be too lazy to throw up some video from his channel, but maybe I'll link it in the description. That's what I'll do. I'll just link it in the description. So look down in the description and click the link. Nothing in my life is really interesting right now. I did get a terrestrial radio show, but you'll never hear it because you got to be in a remote corner of the world to hear it. But hopefully that'll go well. You know, hopefully it'll be a lot more entertaining than this crap right here that I'm doling out to you right now. We'll see. I haven't shaved. The last time I shaved was thousands of miles away. I was literally thousands of miles away from where I am right now. You know, I don't like shaving, but I don't like not having shaved. I'm just going to see how long I can put up with this, with my facial hair. And my facial hair is winning right now. I want to try to give it at least another couple of weeks. See what happens. And I also wanted to see if there's any gray in there. There seems to be like two little patches right on the chin. I think the last time I tried to do this was like 4 years ago and there still wasn't any gray. But there seemed to be a couple of little patches down there. I'm getting really tired right about now, you know. Right about now. I can't even do the voice I'm trying to do. Can't even do it reliably, you know. Can't even do it reliably. Oh, that's terrible. Blah, blah. Get that out of my mouth. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? I had some fun. I got to hang out with some scientists in this place that I was, this very remote. Well, it wasn't very remote, but couple of scientists and an engineer made a little audio presentation with those guys. It was fun. It was a good time had by all. Ate some good food. I should have gotten some fish, but I didn't. That'll be the biggest regret of my life. I should have gotten some fish, but I didn't. I think that pretty much sums up my life right there. All right. More to come. More to come, Mordecai. More to come.